get started. First, we need to measure ourselves up from here, just below the belly button. Just below the belly button, you go here, it is. You go up towards the neck, around the neck, back to the front. That will be the length of the chain you must make. So the chain will be in a multiple of 20 chains plus 10 additional chains. So you start here, you go around the back, back to the front. When you measure it up, don't put any tension on the chain because it must be loosely. After you started the first row, this your chain will shrink at least 10 to 20%. So in order to fit it twice around your neck, you must make sure that your chain fits loosely around your neck. So from the belly button, below the belly button, around the neck, back to the front. That is the length you need, and then we get started. Well, I made these three center pull skeins. These are leftover yarns, similar to Scheepjes Color Crafter. Some of you people already know that one. You need a crochet hook at least one full size bigger than the label of your yarn recommends. We'll start off. You already measured yourself up, and we'll start off with a chain of 20 stitches, multiple of 20 stitches plus 10 additional chains. So I put one loop on my hook. This is a center pull ball, so I don't need to catch this in my kitchen here. So that's really clever of mine to make this. So multiple of 20 stitches. I already put one stitch on my hook, and now we start off with 20 stitches. Here we go. So continue 20 chains plus 10 additional chains. So 20, 20, 20 plus 10 additional chains up until it fits from the belly button, just below the belly button, around the neck, back to the belly button again. I made 4 times 20 stitches plus 10. It's just a sample here, so I don't make the full shawl. For the full shawl you've seen in the picture, it has 190 stitches. Well, I close the chain up here in the first chain I made with a slip stitch. Here it is. Now, we chain up 4. That is 1 double crochet plus chain 1. Here's number 1 for the chain 1. And 1 double crochet in the same stitch where you close the circle in one piece. Here. Here, so the chain 3 is double crochet plus a chain 1. So 4 chains plus a double crochet. Now you crochet in each of the next 8 chains, you will crochet 1 double crochet. So that's the first, the second, the third, here. It does not matter if you put your double crochet underneath one loop or underneath two loops. Here, you see already a V-shaped stitch, 8 double crochets in a row. Now we go crocheting 2 double crochets together. It's over the first and the third stitch, so you skip one stitch in between. In the next stitch you will make a unfinished double crochet. You skip this and you go into the next, and there you make one unfinished double crochet. You've got 1, 2, 3 loops on the hook, wrap around and pull through. Now you've got 2 double crochets together. Next 8 stitches, each you will make 1 double crochet in it. And my last double crochet, number 8, and in the next you will make a V-shaped stitch. So that's a double crochet, chain 1, and another double crochet in the same stitch. Let me show you. Here it is. Well, now you start off with 8 double crochets in a row, and then 2 double crochets together, 8 double crochets in a row. Here's the 2 double crochets together, 8 in a row, and then a V-shaped stitch in the top. You continue up until you're back here, and then we start off the next row. Well, I crocheted around, I finished here. You've got 1 stitch left before you end this row, but we won't end it right now. Let me show you. This side you need to flip over like this. Zoop. Towards you. So that is the first side you start with. So this double crochet here you start with, you bring it towards you. So lay it down here, and then we continue on the other side of the chain. We have one single crochet left over, and that is correct. So here we end off with a V-shaped stitch plus a double crochet. So now we need to make a two double crochet together. Here's the last chain that you have left over of this chain you start with. There you make the first unfinished double crochet. Now you skip the V-shaped stitch from the beginning of the row and you go into the next. Put your hook underneath that loop, pull up, yarn around, pull through two. You've got three loops in the hook and pull through. Now you've got two double crochets together. And continue. So eight double crochets in a row up the hill, because now we made a two double crochets together that's in the valley, and now you need to go up the hill. You see, I put my yarn towards my work, that way I don't have to sew it in later on. It makes it much easier for yourself. I always hate to sew in any tails of the yarn, so put it aside, keep it there, and crochet around it. Saves a lot of time and irritation. So, eight double crochets up the row. And when you're in the top, you will make a V-shaped stitch, so one double crochet, chain one, one double crochet in the same stitch. But here it is. Since it was two double crochets together in the beginning of the row, you have a chain one space here. In that chain one space, there you make the V-shaped stitch. So double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet in the same stitch. And you continue on with the pattern. So eight double crochets in row, two double crochets together, eight in row, V-shaped stitch in the top, up until you're back around here. And there you start closing off this round. This flipping over you will do only one time. Here I finish this row. I'm back at the beginning where it started, so the chain four. Here it is. And we close off this round in a third chain from the bottom. So here it is with a slip stitch. Done. As you have seen in the picture in the beginning, I have changed every row. Well, these two sides is one row. What I will do is chain two. I will cut my yarn very short. I don't leave a long tail here. I'll show you why. The chain two that I make is really clever. I grab this end of the tail, put my nails above the two chains, and will bring it towards my work. So here I pull only on the tail and I put with my nails. I will put those chain two towards my work. That way it is secure. You can't get it loose anymore. If you want to take it out, if you have done a incorrect color or you want to change it, bad luck, because you need to use a scissor to get it out. So no problems with washing. Now I sew in directly my ends. Damn, I'm here in a chain in a slip stitch, not in the double crochet. Well, does not matter. I put my hook through. Show you. Here's the next double crochet. I put my hook from the back to the front. Here, underneath both loops, pick up the loop and pull through. I will repeat this up until I have no yarn left. Well, at least it is almost sewed in. This saves you a lot of time, ladies and gentlemen. So just wrap it in from the front to the back, from the back to the front, and so on and so on, and pull. Done. When you crochet around it here, it has been double secured. Well, here's the front again. It's got double crochet, here's the slip stitch. And in this gap, we'll start off with the next row. So don't turn, just stay here. We turn, we go crochet on the back side of this line. So I put a chain one on my hook, pull up through the chain one space and secure it with an extra chain. And now chain three more, that is a double crochet plus chain one. And in the same chain one space, you make a double crochet. Now you've got a V-shaped stitch and you go along with the stitches. So 8 double crochets in a row. Here's my first. Since I pulled the the slip stitch a bit too tight, it's hard to get my hook in. So that's the only trick you have. Here is my first. I put my yarn around here. Oh, sorry, out of screen. There. And when I make my double crochet, it is secure this little tail. Here is my first double crochet. Put it a bit up and make your next double crochet in the next stitch. You see, when I put my hook underneath the stitch, I get directly underneath the sewed in tail from the gray yarn. Well, continue the same way you done in the beginning, only no flipping overs needed because you already done it. And when you continue this row, you will go automatically around twice and you will end up in the beginning. So there's the chain 4 plus double crochet. Here it is. I'll show you. I just took another color to show you how it looks like. Here's the 2 double crochets together. This stitch here, and skip this one. And then the next will be my 2 double crochets together. So in this stitch, you make an unfinished double crochet, skip the 2 double crochets together from the previous row, and into the next you make an unfinished double crochet, 3 loops and hook, and pull through. And so on and so on. So 8 double crochets up the hill. Number 2. Number 3. Number 4. 5, 6, number 7, number 8, and a V-shaped stitch in the chain 1 space from the previous row. And I'll show you how it looks like. Here it is. When you go around, you will come automatically back here. And then you will close this round off with a chain, with a single crochet, with a slip stitch in the 3rd chain. Just to show you, we done here the flip over, and I don't need it now because it's already done for me. So go along with the stitches and you will end up in the beginning where you started with. Here I am. So end up with 8 double crochets. I will find my 3rd chain. And in that third chain, I will close this round up with a slip stitch. Here it is. Ta-da! Well, if you like to change the color again, like I have done, chain 2, cut the yarn very short and move up the 2 chains. If you rather crochet with 1 yarn only, then chain 1 is single crochet 1 in the chain 1 space. And make 1 chain plus 3 more additional chains in order to create a double crochet chain 1 and 1 more double crochet in that chain 1 space. And then you can start off with the next row. So when you use, for example, Red Heart Boutique Unforgettable, you can do it like this. So that's a self-striping yarn, so you don't need to change colors every row. If you use stash yarn, change color every round. So chain up 2, cut the yarn, pull the loop through, pick up the tail with 2 fingers, put your nails above the chain 2, 1, 2, here, and move it up. Then you feel a tiny little bump here, but when you crochet over it in the next row, you won't feel it anymore. So here again, from the pull the loops through underneath 2 loops, continue up until your tail is gone or almost gone. You don't need to sew it in completely because when I stretch it here, it is gone. And next row you will start here. Every row you need to turn. Well, I already turned, so I can start here in this stitch. Crochet as long as much rows you want, and I hope to see your picture.